that womb got that power. It discords all those chems, radiation, pollution, and contaminations. That is in this modern context. These three chems are asuras. Asuras means it is not that they are as it is projected in Chandamama or in your so-called medias. It is only negative forces working in antariksha, atmosphere and many other spheres. That is called asura. So this asura shakti to be discarded. So it is samhara. Srishti sthiti samhara. So that for all these three important functions, we must take Omkara first. Those who are ready to discard this external frame for taking a new birth, so they are about to die. That word is not at all good in our system, tradition. No death as such exists in our Indian tradition. It is only you are discarding, that is all. Your frame, external frame, vasamsi jirnani yatha vihaya. So that those old thoughts we have to remove. So we are there to remove. But by removing that old, jaded, old cloth, t-shirt, coffee shirt, you must pronounce this Om. As we pronounce, our 101 nadis will be activated. That is the science behind that. When we go for pronouncing Om, all this important web in our upper chamber area, 101 nadis, they will be activated. So that prana sanchara will be so easy. And through that nadi, sukshma, our prana, he will have very easy passage to go out, so that without so much pain, we will give up that car, that old shirt, and become free for adopting new t-shirt. That is the mechanism in this. So, when these Polish people make the whole passage free, in all those signals they make free passage for so-called VIPs, when they come fast, those VIPs. Dignitaries come fast because whole passage is made free for free movement. Like that, we have to do our whole passage free. For that also, Omkara Anuttam. So that our whole web free, so that prana through this Brahmarandra goes to Urthuloka. That is the mechanism behind it. That is why Omkara got its own very special role even while creating this wonderful world and while maintaining in the sustenance of this world. Again, for destruction, all these type of activities, srishti sthiti samhara karya, Omkara got its own role. And very important thing is, Om is the mula. Om Samaveda Parampara. Om Iti Brahma, Om Iti Lagum Sarvam, Om Iti Gagalokrati Hasvava Api Aposhravayanti Ashravayanti, Om Iti Samani Gayanti. That is how Upanishad says. Om Samani Gayanti. Samaveda is the root for whole Sangeeta Parampara. Sangeeta Parampara. Great time-tested lady. It started from Samaveda. Samaveda came through Brahma's divine mouth. That is how we adore Sangeetha tradition. We respect that Sangeetha parampara. That parampara is very well remembered today, because we have one more parampara that is called Vagheyakara parampara. Vagheyakara means Vakara and Gheyakara. Both they create literature and compose with proper tuning. And Sangeetha and Sahitya both are combined their personality. That is how Saraswati is so evident in their personality. Saraswati got two important eyes, Sangeetha, Sahitya, Sahitya, Sangeetha. So Tyagaraja, the great spiritual master of Sangeetha tradition, is very well remembered today. So Tyagaraja, he composed Bhakti Rasayana. Bhakti Rasayana, that is juice of devotion he gave to us. He enriched that tradition. For us, this Sangeetha is not something secular or something mundane. Now everything we make it mundane, everything we make it secular, that means make it free from spiritual touch. As soon as you make any aspect of life free from spiritual touch, it becomes so-called secular. Then it is so-called secular means it is always materialistic, always selfish. It is always used in the market. And when it comes to the market, it will be sold out. So then competition starts. So now Sahitya, Sangeetha, all these great spiritual aspects also became marketing. They are marketing things. They are somewhere displayed in the open markets. So there will be trade, commerce, all these competitions, cutthroat competitions, all this stuff. But it was not approved by our tradition. We have no right to do all these things. When you make yoga also something displayed in the market, Veda marketed, Yaga is marketed, Yoga is marketed, Sangeetha also displayed in the open market. When all is becoming a mall market aspects, mall culture, market culture, when it comes immediately, its whole pranashakti starts diminishing, and leading to total destruction. We cannot allow this one. We yoga people cannot do that. As we repeatedly tell about yoga here, this yoga is not something, that type of yoga which is sold out in the open market. Our yoga is supported by Vedantic insight. It's Atma yoga. That's what we emphatically assert here. Okay, it's good. Like the Sangeetha, it also must have divine touch. Now everything cinema. No, we don't want it. We want divinized everything. Divinized. So Sangeetha divinized. Shishir vetti, pashur vetti, vetti, gonarasam pani. That is how all these Vagheyakaras like Tyagaraja, Purandaradasa, Dikshitar, all these great personalities of Dakshinamurti Karnataka Sangeetha, like that Tansen and many others, Uttarada Sangeetha, these two streams have come down to this modern world. Even now in this so-called marketing world also, many people, they maintain the purity of tradition. So with that insight, today let us remember Tyagaraja. Understand? Close your eyes. Contemplate on this thought process. Just bring that divine personality, Vagheyakara personality of Tyagaraja to your mind. Remember that great tradition, Sangeetha tradition. It is called emotional culture. Our emotions must be cultured and nurtured. Mind must be free from negative waves. For that we must bring divine music. It helps culturing of our emotions. So Sangeeta, it is part of Chikitsa. It helps for Swasthya. So the tradition of great musicians, Vakyakaras like Tyagaraja, remember? Let us remember that Om Srishti Nada, all in Nada, please follow. Om Iti Kaksharam Brahma.
Shanti, Shanti.